Why, Mr. Bailey?
Through nature's tragedy, we find unity when we come together. Racism, we feel shame. No one wants to take the blame. Through the fire, we all will hang. With love, we can change when we all come together.
Afternoon, good evening, and good morning somewhere out there in the world. You're listening to Sound Off with EVE here on WLTH Radio, AM 1370, the region's choice. And the views expressed by the host and callers of this show are not necessarily the views of WLTH Radio management, owners, and sponsors. Certainly an interesting day today. It's Tuesday, and the weather is dropping. Remember what I said yesterday, right? Well, yep. It's actually what's beautiful throughout the morning, and it just starting to drop, and you should always be prepared for this weather, because you just never know. You know, you have a sweatshirt on, always have a jacket with you, a coat with you. You just never know when it starts dropping. But I want to give a shout out to those of you that are listening to me right now, and if you are viewing me, yes, I have something in front of me. Ta-da! Yes, I have my tablet. It's on, and I am working it. Follow me on Twitter, and that's at official Eve G. And for those of you that like to email me things to do with the media, things you'd like for me to announce, or if you want information pertaining to that, you can go to Eve Enterprise.
Gomez Enterprise.
Eve Gomez. Sorry. EveGomezEnterprise@gmail.com. That's EveGomezEnterprise@gmail.com. And remember to follow me. I will start actually hopefully soon in the next few days. I just got to get the hang of all this technology. Do Twitter chats so that you can join in the conversation that I'm having on Twitter, also live here on the radio. And remember to sound off with EVE at 215-885-1371. That's 885-1371. And, you know, sometimes Facebook is good. It can help you, but it can also hurt you sometimes, right? But what can help is we can find out information about our dear friends, what's going on with their families. And I happen to have been looking on Facebook yesterday, and I was looking at a friend's status, and found out that her mom had a heart attack. So my prayers are going out to the Fontaine family. I pray that Ms. Celia gets well and speedy recovery, Godspeed, and family also to hang in tight. You know, things that sometimes come to you as a surprise, unexpected, can actually worry you. So my prayers are with the family. Shout out to the family, to Ed, to Leachy, to out there in Maryville, Crown Point, St. John, East Chicago, all my Garyites here and my Hammondites as well. And quick shout out to David Wright from the GPTC as well, or GPTD, I'm sorry, the Gary Public Transportation. So good news that they're moving around and they're going to do some transportation out in Hammond, and that's great. That's great news because we do need transportation. I believe East Chicago has their own transportation, and Gary has it too, but we're going to move around Hammond and different locations. So I'm going to bring actually the marketing director, the person that would be in charge next week, to come on and discuss their routes, discuss what's in their plans, discuss why they decided to do that. So it'll give you guys the opportunity to ask questions about the Gary Public Transportation's change in improvement in routes. And, you know, as I say, Transportation Board approves the Hammond route, bus route. Okay, I don't know what happened here. I guess I exceeded my limit, it says, so I got to delete some things. I have, I guess, too many sites open, huh? Is that what that means, Mars? It says 417 rate limit exceeded for engine pages.
I have no idea what you're talking about because I never do what you do, which is not multitasking, but completely overloading all of your devices.
I had 7 pages. Actually, I had 10 pages open.
I honestly don't know how you do these things with technology, Mom.
Oh, it's called I need to learn how to close things.
The ace wonder of the world, I swear.
That's just what makes me who I am, unique. You might call it crazy, but that's okay.
Yeah, a little bit more than crazy.
Transportation approves new Hammond bus route. The Gary Public Transportation Corp board, by a vote of 5-0 on Thursday, approved a new bus route in Hammond. I know this isn't new news, but I will have David Wright come on and talk to us about what's going on with that. What routes are they thinking of doing? What plans they're having? How did it change? I mean, how did it come up with the idea? So tune in for next week. I'll have David Wright come on, and he will be coming on the 18th, and that will be Tuesday, the 18th. And also this Thursday, we'll have someone from Acción Chicago. She speaks both languages, but we're going to have her come on to talk about small businesses, how we can help you grow as a small business. We believe that if we don't qualify to get a job, but we're passionate about something, I think that becoming an entrepreneur is the way to go. That's just, you know, my opinion on it, my thought, because I, too, am an entrepreneur. I own my own business, EG Spanish Interpreting and Consulting, LLC, and I'm blessed to be able to do that and to open doors for other people as well. And speaking of open doors for other people, we're going to find out from the GPTC is are they going to have employment? Are they going to hire more people? Is that an opportunity for hire? So tune in on Tuesday for that, and I will be scheduling more guests to come on here on WLTH Radio. Remember to sound off at 219-885-1371. So that's so I know that we're moving forward, okay, with that. As far as transportation is concerned. I was looking at some pictures. Oh, my God. I can't share this one. A fried rat. Have you guys ever heard of fried rats? Ew. I don't know if you guys can see it, but can you see that, Mars? Ew. Ugh. Look, we have mice. I can't see them. I can't stand them. Imagine eating them. Fried rats. What do you guys think about fried rats? What do you think about that, Omar?
Good source of protein.
Excuse me?
I said a good source of protein.
Do you guys like that? Oh. Wow. Hey, what do you call those little cars?
Right. Smart there cars?
Front? Smart car? They look like your toy car that you move it back and let it go. Remember those little cars you had, Mars? What do they run on? Electricity?
That I don't know. I think they're gas-powered. They're just really fuel efficient.
Why are they? Oh, is that what they call them? Smart cars?
Something like that.
Really? I need to stop talking? Oh, I'm sorry. I have a live audience there, and they're going to give me the signal to stop talking. Well, this is talk radio. It can't be talk radio without me talking. Anyway, if I can read lips, I certainly wouldn't know exactly what she's saying.
I think she means get back on your topics, ma'am.
Well, too bad I can't speak in Spanish because you won't understand everything I'm saying here. Some of you probably understand what I would say, but that'll be left for Friday and Saturday program. How about that? I was looking at jokes because we need laughter here. We truly do need laughter. The thing is that we often are too stressed out or too upset or too angry to really think and feel about wanting to laugh. And this morning I had the opportunity, I'm giving a shout out to all my 30 students in English class. I got to visit them this morning and spend some time talking to them today. And I was walking in the hallways, and for those that are listening and go to a school, I hope you pay attention to what's posted on the walls. Most students don't. That's what I gathered today. I asked the whole class, what did they see in the hallway today? I don't know, for those of you that are tuning in, if you can see that. There's a big banner or sign on the walls of the hallway. There's one that says success, there's one that says pride, but this big one is big yellow with a sunshine. You know, I love sunshine. For those of you that are on my Facebook, actually, can see my sunshines, and I love it. Well, this is a great message that was placed on the wall of a high school hallway. And the sign says, today's preparation determines tomorrow's success. So I ask ninth graders if they can define that, if they can tell me what that means. So they gave me their different definitions. But I did ask them if they had seen that sign. They pass it every day. Well, it depends on what side of the hallway they come through, but they have to pass it at least once throughout the week. And they had never seen that sign. As big as it is, it stands up 3 feet tall, I think, if not taller than that. But that's a great message, don't you agree? Preparation. So I discussed the preparation to determine their success. That if they don't prepare with a positive attitude in the morning, just to have a successful day. Didn't think about 5 years from now, didn't talk about 10 years from now, just the day, because I told these kids that today is their day. It's about them, not about us. I did stress some important points about starting the day with a smile, something simple, given for free. I said, I love to smile, and I saw some beautiful smiles. I told a few of them, say, smile, because they were not smiling. I said, okay, I asked a question that 30 of them said they were not morning people. Well, I know what happens when you're not a morning person. You don't wake up with a smile. Well, I just went out and told them that in order for them to prepare their day for success, to have a great day, it all starts with them and how they wake up, their demeanor, their attitude. It's all about attitude, to feel good about themselves. And a wise friend, you guys heard here as well, because I can't take credit for what I don't do, so I give credit what credit is due. Treat yourself as you want to be treated. Not the common phrase that you guys hear, as in treat others as you want to be treated, as you have them want to treat you. It's treat yourself as you want to be treated. So I had to went on and explain that as well for the kids, and they said it made sense. So I left them some homework for tomorrow. Will they remember to look at that sign? Will they remember to prepare for the day? And it all starts with them, in their mind and in their heart. So it was 30 students. I left with a positive message, and as I told them, it's all about them. And I told them that I love them because I do. I care what happens to them, each and every one of them. I'll have them for the rest of the year and for next year as well. And you have to be thankful. And I also let them know that I was on my way to juvie. And those kids there in Lake County Juvenile Detention Center are only misunderstood. And I bring that to all of you here on WLTH radio and live streaming. It's for the reason that things are happening everywhere that we all have to start changing the mindset, not only of our youth, but of ourselves, our adults, the ones that are ruling the country right now, the ones that are ruling the schools right now, the ones that are ruling and governing the town, the city, the county, the state, the country. We have to start changing that mindset. And so with that, I was reading an article, hope I can find it, because I open up articles and I had to close some windows here, pertaining to the guns, and it was great, and I remembered, I emailed it to you, Omar. I emailed that to you. Really killed by a gun. And as I shared with you guys what took place this past weekend, I want to give a shout out to all the moms that are out there, Parents for Peace and Justice, Robert, Eddie, Robert, Ailey, Liz, moms, wives. Thank you for bringing me and making part of change, because change, all it takes is one person to make a change, to make a difference. So I want to read this headlines that's been sent to me. I do get columns from Marion Wright Edelman's Child Watch under the Children's Defense Fund. You ought to look that up. You'll find some interesting information. And I may sound redundant or boring. I'm sorry, but this is real talk. I won't try to read word for word, but it's important information. Killed by a gun. Guns don't kill. People that use them do. But that's what this is titled. Hello. As the headlines in the case were sadly familiar, an angry adult armed with a gun used it to shoot and kill an unarmed black teenager. I know this may sound, again, for those of you that are tuning in here on WLTH Radio, hopefully you are driving and pay attention to your driving, but tune in and listen. And then, of course, the lines will always be open. I'd like to hear some feedback from you. So as it says, a gun used is to shoot and kill an unarmed black teenager. He thought seemed, quote, bad this time because the teenager and his friends were sitting in a car listening to music the grown-up didn't like. In this outrageous Florida case, a middle-aged white man, Michael Dunn, was convicted of 3 counts of attempted murder and 1 count of shooting a gun into an occupied car. Jurors agreed he faced no threat after he was annoyed by loud music coming from a car he had deliberately chosen to park next to, and then started an argument, pulled a gun on the car's black teens, and fired 3 shots at the young men inside the car as they tried to drive away from him. I'm just reading. If there were more than that, I'm just reading. But the jury could not agree on the most serious charge of first-degree murder for shooting the first 7 bullets at the stationary car and hitting a 17-year-old Jordan Davis in his lung, liver, and aorta. Florida's notorious stand-your-ground, quote, law, which gives gun owners a license to kill if they feel threatened, was allegedly enough for 3 jurors to vote against conviction. At least 1 juror said she believed Michael Dunn did get away with murder. There is no longer a Jordan Davis. There's only 1 reason why that is. The boy was shot and killed for reasons that should not have happened. Quote, an interview with Good Morning America, Jordan's mother, Lucia McBath, said she believed the jurors in her son's case did the best they could with the laws they had, but also made it clear she believes our nation's existing laws did not protect Jordan or millions of other victims of gun violence in America. When asked what justice for her son would look like, she answered, really, when we change the laws, ultimate justice for Jordan will be ultimately really when we change the laws, she said. Because that will not be just justice for Jordan and justice for Trayvon and justice for all the children of Sandy Hook, justice for Aurora and justice for Virginia Tech, justice for Chicago and the Navy Yard. It will be justice for everyone that has suffered because of these laws and will continue to suffer. So once the laws are changed, that's the ultimate justice for all. You guys agree on that or not? Well, researchers at Texas A&M University studied the impact of stand your ground laws, like the one enacted in Florida in 2005, across the country, and concluded in 2012 study that the laws do not deter burglary, robbery, or aggravated assault, but do lead to a statistically significant 8% net increase in the number of reported murders and non-negligent manslaughters. Evidence is also clear that these laws have a disparate racial impact. Researchers from the Urban Institute found that when white shooters kill black victims, 34% of the homicides are deemed justifiable, while only 3.3% are ruled justifiable when the nation or when the situation is reversed. Now, researchers from the Johns Hopkins Center for Gun Policy and Research have released the results of a new study on the effectiveness of another crucial segment of our nation's gun laws, those requiring background checks before purchasing a gun. For this study, the scholars took a close look at the state of Missouri 2007 repeal of its permit to purchase law. Before it was repealed, this law required all handgun purchasers in Missouri to obtain a license verifying that they had passed a background check. The researchers wanted to know what happened when this requirement was taken away, and they learned that repealing that law has led to a 16% increase in Missouri's murder rate. Wow. The study showed between 2008 and 2012, there were an additional 55 to 63 murders in Missouri each year associated with the law's repeal. During those same years, the national murder rate dropped by over 5%. The research controlled for changes in policy, incarceration, burglaries, unemployment, poverty, and other laws adopted during the study period that could affect violent crime. The spike in murders only occurred for murders committed with a gun and happened statewide, while bordering states showed no increase. The number of handguns recovered from scenes of crimes or from criminal quickly doubled after the appeal. In a press release, lead author Daniel Webster, SCD, MPH, director of Johns Hopkins Center for Gun Policy and Research, said, quote, "This study provides compelling confirmation that weaknesses in firearm laws lead to deaths from gun violence," quote, co-author John Burnick, JD, MPH, deputy director for the Center for Gun Policy and Research, added, "Because many perpetrators of homicide have backgrounds that would prohibit them from possessing firearms under federal law, they seek out private sellers to acquire their weapons. Requiring a background check on all gun sales is a common sense approach to reducing gun violence that does not infringe upon the Second Amendment rights of law-abiding gun owners." Requiring a background check seems like common sense to most Americans, you would think, and yet some lawmakers refuse to make it happen. Otherwise, like those in Missouri, are actually moving backwards. The same press release noted only 15 states, you hear that? 15 states require individuals purchasing handguns from unlicensed sellers to pass background checks, with 10 of these states requiring all purchasers to acquire a permit to purchase license. A 2013 public opinion survey from Johns Hopkins found the majority of Americans, 89%, and gun owners, 84%, support requiring a background check system for all gun sales. The majority of Americans, 77%, and gun owners, 59%, also reported supporting requiring people to obtain a license from a local law enforcement agency before buying a gun to verify their identity and to ensure that they are not legally prohibited from having a gun. This latest Johns Hopkins study is another key step in finding out what works to reduce gun violence. Well, we all need to work on that. The available evidence is clear. Stand your ground laws do not reduce gun violence. Background checks do. Just one part of a network of solutions that can help. We need a robust commitment to much more research on the epidemic public health threat of gun violence to identify all of them. And we know what works. We need leaders who will listen to and act on the research and public opinion to preserve lives. You guys hear that? We need leaders to work on this. who will listen to act to and act on the research and public opinion to preserve lives. We do not need any more suffering families. Jordan Davis' father, Ron, said, all the other 17-year-olds out there, they shouldn't have to fear the adults with guns that are running around here shooting them at will. If you throw popcorn in someone's face, they want to shoot you because you threw popcorn in their face. That's what we've come to. But we have to stop. We really do have to stop. Too many parents are crying out there due to violence. What are your thoughts about Stand Your Ground? Is it good? Is it bad? It's got its flaws, because that has not decreased the gun violence. I believe that is actually increasing it. You're listening to Sound Off with EVE here on WLTH Radio, the region's choice sound off number, 219-885-1371.
Mommy, I have a toothache.
Honey, my tooth is loose.
If you've been looking for a dentist, you're in luck. Radcliffe Family Dental, located at 1901 Grant Street in Gary, provides dental care for the whole family. Starting now, Radcliffe will be taking new patients, and you could be one of them by calling 219-880-1430. That's 219-880-1430. Call for an appointment today. Dr. Radcliffe, a dentist with many years of experience, and her team will be glad to help put a smile on you. Get pearly white at Radcliffe Family Dental this year. Radcliffe Family Dental offers cleaning, teeth whitening, white or silver fillings, crowns and bridges, digital x-rays, complete dentures, implant crowns, extractions, and laughing gas if you need a pep in your step. Radcliffe Family Dental, your new dental home. Visit us at 1901 Grant Street in Gary or call 219-880-1430. Hours Monday through Thursday from 8 a.m. till 4 p.m. Closed Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We accept most insurance, including Medicaid and Calumet Township.
Can you play it? Welcome back, WLTH Radio. I'm sorry, I can't always read signs. You know, I should learn sign language, but the only sign language I know is I love you. I think that's how you do it, right? Kiss to you all for listening here on WLTH Radio. Thank you so much for following me on Twitter and on Facebook. It's All About You with EVE. Oh, and we are the American Red Cross supporters. Omar donates blood as soon as he's available to do it, which is every, 6 weeks, 8 weeks?
Yep, 56 days.
Every 56 days?
Yep.
And we are saving approximately about 3 lives.
Yep, the blood gets separated into 3 different parts that can be used. So that's up to 3 lives right there.
And that's great. So I just got a message about Red Cross, and I'm going to get a representative of Red Cross to come here and discuss how that can actually help build your immune system stronger. You don't get sick as often when you are donating blood frequently. Your cholesterol level actually drops when you're doing that. Go figure, huh? So I'll bring an educated person that'll tell me or tell you how that works. It's, I don't know, I guess it's something to do with the blood when it's being, I guess it comes back to your body. What's the word, Mars, when you're giving?
Recycling?
I don't know if I call blood recycling.
when you know, you're giving blood, so you have a loss of blood, then your body generates new blood. So it's kind of like...
Regenerating?
Regenerating, there you go.
Is that the word, I think?
Yes, I mean, it's a word you can use.
Yeah. Oh, and also you can find some of these videos of my show on YouTube, and that's at Official Eve G. Or just type in Eve Gomez, and you'll see the lovely picture that Omar created with the information. Certainly love it. But I was looking for a song, and I speak from the heart. Speaking of from the heart, on Wednesdays, the Pennsylvania Center, We Care from the Heart. You guys heard my friend here, Ed Mintz, come on and talk about giving away free phones. It's important. I'm going to have them or him, I'm waiting for a call, to give free phones
to the families at the juvenile center, because I hear, whether they're excuses or true reasons, that they don't have a phone and they couldn't contact the parent when a kid, you know, their child got detained on the weekend. And of course, they got to come and appear in court on Monday. And sometimes they don't have a phone. So how are you going to get a hold of them? And sometimes these kids are on public aid. The parents are on public aid. They're receiving a Medicaid card. And those are the qualifications. Those are the requirements. So I thought, what a great thing to do. Have them there also to give away phones. So he will be at the Pennsylvania Center on Tuesdays, bless you, from 1 to 5 on a regular basis. So that's great. I'm glad that the connection is there. We Care from the Heart at the Pennsylvania Center in East Chicago, Indiana. That is going to be one of the locations that he will be there on a weekly basis, or as he said, a regular basis, on Tuesdays, 1 to 5 at the Pennsylvania Center. So you guys heard the requirements before. If you don't know what they are, call me. We'll get in touch, and we'll place him in different locations, because people can't always afford a cell phone, and you get 275 free minutes per month with a free phone. So you're receiving SSI, if you're receiving public aid, Medicaid. All you need is your ID and your Medicaid card or your SSI letter. So that's great. So give a shout out to Ed. Great work. So we just got to keep making a difference. That's all. What's so hard about that? One person can make a difference, and that person could be you. Why not? There's nothing to lose, really. A couple of hours here and there. You get rewarded anyway when you see somebody smiling, when you see a family happy, when you see someone crying to you and saying, thank you so much. You're a blessing to me. Because, see, God works through people. Nothing mysterious about that. That's what I'm saying. 219-885-1371. You want to sound off here with me? You can call 219-885-1371. Omar, wake up and go to sleep. So anyway, I'm opening my new office at the Innovation Center. So I'm going to do my quick commercial here on WLTH Radio. Translator, interpreter, and I deal with marketing. So you can say consultant. 5209 Holman Avenue, up in the second floor. So the Office Innovation Center, that one of the directors will be here to discuss how to become a small business owner, but more than anything is how can we build an innovation center in Gary, in East Chicago? Incubators, it's needed. The potential is here. We just need the willing bodies, willing and able bodies that are passionate enough to do it. If you get a group of people that are passionate enough, the money will follow. Because people say we need money. How can we do it without the money? So if we have enough passionate people, the money will follow. Agree or disagree? 219-885-1371 is 30 minutes after the hour. Coach's Corner is coming up after this show at 6 o'clock, as always. I had a song, and I'm looking for the right singer, Mars Soldier. I'll have to go for one of those that are up on that board there. So I'll be right back after this, 219-885-1371. right. Welcome back to Sound Off with EVE. Give a shout out to Cleveland. Shout out to Sam. Sam, I got to fire you up, huh? Well, let's see. Let's bring some things you want me to talk about. Other than keeping things real and talk about real issues, people really have issues, to be honest with you. Many more than before have a lot of issues. And then you know what the problem is? They want to make it your issue. They want to make it your problem. They want to blame you for their reaction. Is that something right or something fair? They got all angry and upset for what I said. So I get the blame because of their reaction. That's how they took it. So is it my fault that they got upset? That's the choice they made to react that way. And that's what I always say. It's not the action that matters, it's the reaction that does. And I did give that message to our youth as well, to my 30 students this morning. And I had them write it down because I have homework for them. I'll be back in their class tomorrow. And that's one of the phrases. Besides, if it is to be, it is up to me. But that action speaks louder than words also. But remember, it's not the action that matters, it's the reaction that does. It's 44 minutes after the hour. Sam, we got to fire you up, so we got to bring in some great things. We got to talk about respect. That's something that I told the kids today, too. Respect. Do they even know what that is anymore? They can't even respect themselves. What's wrong with our community? What's wrong with our society now? Backwards, isn't it? So we need to clean up our act, but we need to clean up the mentality that our youth are carrying with. But parents, you got to start first. I just cannot stop saying it. It starts at home. Parents, you need to be that front soldier. Put them in that right path. Don't do things that they're going to start repeating and saying it. Because especially babies, 3, 4, 5-year-olds, they're like sponges. They absorb all that. And they observe what you do. And they copy you in school, at a doctor's office, out on the street, in a bus, in a train. They copy you. And then they're going to embarrass you. And then you're not going to like it. So parents, pay attention. You are the kid's mirror. You're your children's mirror. And they're looking at you. Kids, 3, 4, 5-year-olds are cursing up a storm. Yeah, we think they're cute videos and they're funny videos when we look them up on YouTube or we see them on Facebook liking these videos of a 3-year-old. Yeah, I saw one, and I had to listen to the whole thing. People thought it was funny. A 2-year-old, a 3-year-old, kept using the MF word, the F word, the SH word throughout that whole 5-minute video, calling his or her mother a B as well. The mother was calling the child the same thing, and they were laughing, videotaping this. That's child abuse, psychological abuse. And people are getting away with it left and right. We're such a controlling country, we don't protect our children, huh? For a country that likes to fight for freedom, why don't we fight for our children? What's wrong with that picture? 47 minutes after the hour, I'm just a soldier of love. That's all I am here, sharing the love, but you got to learn to respect yourself. Be right back. I picked a song that I'd like for you to listen. And continue to listen to Sound Off with EVE here on WLTH Radio. For all those soldiers that are out there fighting the fight, fighting for justice, fighting for peace, this is for you. Be that soldier that you meant to be.
I'm a soldier of all the days of my life.
Right, welcome back to Sound Off with EVE. I remember back in the days when I used to get all fired up early in the morning from 6 to 9 on Fridays. And I know some of you have been listening to me since then. The difference is I don't have full control of what my spirit wants to do because now we have a board operator. And I love it because it's my son doing it. We're two different people. I got to ask him to play certain things. It doesn't come as fresh, as quick as I want things to flow because I'm not in control of everything except what I have here. So if you want to hear some stuff that you need to be more fired up, just call me. Let me know. All right? I am public. You can Google me. You can find me. It's a good thing, but it's also a bad thing because there's crazy people out there, people that are obsessed, that are... stalkers and all that. But I do have to watch my back. I do have to be careful. But I am out there. And speaking of out there, the Mayor's of Disabilities Breakfast, the Mayor's Organization of Disabilities Breakfast will be on the 19th here at Gary, Indiana. That's coming up next week. So I'll be bringing information about different events that are coming up out in the community, in the region. I know I missed the Hammond's Breakfast. But I feel more connected here in Gary for some reason, but it's a good reason. So it's almost time to say goodbye for today or say see you later. 52 minutes after the hour. I want to thank all of you for tuning in here on WLTH Radio. I'll bring some more powerful stuff during the week. Bring some news to you, what's going on around in the world in 60 seconds here on WLTH Radio. Sound Off with EVE. Omar, I love the song and it sends a positive message because peace and justice is what we always have to spread and share among the world. With that, I want to say until tomorrow at 5 o'clock, so tune in tomorrow. See where I'll be, if here at the studio or somewhere out there. Somewhere out there in the world. Thank you for tuning in. Gotta love life. It's what I do, so be safe out there. The temperature is going to be dropping. There's going to be a possible chance of snow tonight. Just remember to be prepared for what's to come. Don't complain anymore, guys, because it doesn't bring anything faster, as in spring, as in most of you are certainly waiting for it, dying for it. Well, it's going to be snowing tomorrow. I know it was high 50 degrees tomorrow. Today it's going to drop to 23 degrees. Tomorrow will be 26. It's going to drop to 8 degrees. So, yes, back to the scarves and the gloves. The mittens and the double clothing. So with that, I'm going to leave you with the wonderful song, Never Forgotten. Continue to listen to Sound Off with EVE Monday through Friday at 5 o'clock. Be safe. Thank you.
You're listening to the Region's Choice, AM 1370 Radio. Stay tuned. More talk, more news, and more info. WLTH.
People talking, trying to pick us up. Why won't they let us be? Bricks and stones, they break my mold, but talk don't bother me. People talking, trying to pick us up when they know that I love you so. So I don't care what the people may say, I'll never, never let you go. I've been